We just saw several software process models, and there are many, many more. And because these process models define the master plan for our project, the specific process model that we choose has as much influence over a project's success as any other major planning decision that we make. Therefore, it is very important that we pick the appropriate model for our development process. Picking an appropriate model can ensure the success of a project. On the contrary, if we choose the wrong model, that can be a constant source of problems, and ultimately, it can make the project fail. So how can we choose the right model for a project? To be able to do so, we have to take into consideration many factors. In particular, we need to be aware of what level of understanding we have of the requirements. Do we understand all the requirements? Are we going to be able to collect all the requirements in advance? Or collecting requirements is going to be hard, and therefore we might want to follow a process that is more flexible with that respect. Another important point is the expected lifetime of the project. Is this a quick project that we're putting together for a specific purpose, or something that is going to last for a number of years and that we're going to maintain over all those years? That's going to make a difference in the way we decide to develop that project. Also, what is the level of risk involved? Do we know the domain very well? Do we know exactly the technologies involved? Well, if so, we might go with a more traditional process. Otherwise, we might want to be more agile, more flexible. It is also very important to know the schedule constraints. How much time, how many resources do we have for this project? What is the expected interaction with the management and the customer? In particular for this latter, there are many processes that rely on the fact that there can be a continuous interaction with the customer. If that interaction is not there, there's no way we are going to be able to use these processes. Conversely, there are processes that don't require the presence of the customer at all, except for the initial phase and maybe some check-in points. And so if the customer is very inaccessible, we might want to follow one of those processes instead of one of the more demanding ones in terms of customer time. Finally, it is important to take into account the level of expertise of the people involved. Do we have people that know the technologies that we're using? Do we know people that know a specific kind of process? Some processes require some specific expertise, and we're not going to be able to follow that process if we don't have the right expertise. So we need to take into account all of these aspects, and sometimes more, in order to be able to make the right decision and pick the right software process model for our project.